Hello, Chef Lee here. Today we're making hummus. This is the typical hummus bi tahini, which just simply means hummus with tahini. Now the tahini is the sesame seed paste that is typically used for seasoning in a lot of Middle Eastern cooking. So in the food processor bowl here, I started with 1 cup of garbanzo beans. This is 1 cup of dried beans that I actually put in our pressure cooker with water, and we simmered it in the pressure cooker for about 45 minutes, drained it, cooled it, and that's what we have here. So this is 1 cup dried, but has been cooked, obviously. Now to that, we're gonna add just about 3 tablespoons of lemon juice. Now notice I didn't add all of it at once because we're gonna taste it a little bit along the way and check for flavor. We're also adding about 3 tablespoons, this is 3 tablespoons actually, of tahini. Now again, the tahini is the paste of sesame seeds. So, great flavoring. Hummus really cannot be typically made without it. And then I'm gonna throw in 3 cloves of garlic. I like mine a little extra garlicky. I found that the hummus actually becomes very medicinal when you use a good amount of garlic and olive oil both. Been eating hummus now steadily for over a decade. And I haven't had so much as a single cold in a decade because of the amount of garlic and olive oil that we eat in our diets. So this is one of my mainstays, this is my hummus here. Now from this recipe we can add things like sriracha sauce or jalapenos or what have you, make it a spicy hummus as well, but today I want to show you the basic hummus here. I'm also adding in a pinch of salt, kosher salt, and then I want to add in some olive oil. Now we're going to thin it down with some olive oil. Altogether you probably need about 1/2 cup. While the food processor is running, I'm going to add in some olive oil to get it to the consistency that I like. And you can see that. You can see what's going on with that here in a moment. See if our hummus is finished here. You can see that I added a little more lemon juice during the processing to adjust the consistency a little. Now you want to taste to make sure the salt content and the acid of lemon are all balanced. That is awesome. That is really good. So again, just adjust the salt content and the lemon juice a little bit to flavor to how you like it. And that's it. That's the basic hummus. I use this hummus in a lot of my sandwiches and in my flatbreads for my lunches every day. So it's a great product. We use this a lot instead of mayonnaise, frankly. I use hummus. So a good healthy alternative. So enjoy it!